hey, good morning. Brian up here in Kingfield, Maine. We've got another cool one to show off. I gotta figure out how to start these different where I don't say, this is a really cool one, this is one I love, because I say that in every video. But this one is a really cool one, and I really like it. This is an early 70s, Norland era Gibson J-45. And I just love the top. This gorgeous, like, caramel, you know, caramel apple, cherry, sunburst, whatever you want to call it, with these really cool nitro-crazing streaks down in the belly. It just sort of looks flamey. It looks like the thing's on fire, and I just love it. And I got this from someone who's become a buddy of mine, a guy that's bought a couple guitars from me, and then he sent a couple my way as well. Jason, you know who you are if you're watching this. And it needed some work, and it's a Norland era. Now, we all have heard about the Norland era, and that's what this one is. And Norland era guitars, you know, when Norland Corporation owned Gibson, I think they really were more worried about making sure they had no warranty claims than they were about making a guitar that sounds good. And so they really overbraced them and overstructured them. And then what's really funny, this is the third one I've done, is that even with all this extra bracing and structure, the braces seem to come out. They come apart. So this one came to me with like one brace loose inside, kind of sticking out of the sound hole. You can see a picture of that. I'll try to remember to stick it in the listing. But what they're really known for is their dreaded double X bracing. And what's really kind of cool on this one, if you look at it in the light, you can actually see where that second X was. These tops are pretty thin. You know, they're about a tenth of an inch thick. And for some reason, that bracing on the back starts to bleach through. There, that really shows it there. So you really see how the setup was. So you've got your traditional X up top, which does the major structure. And then what Norland Gibson did is they did this second X. See if I can do this while I'm looking at the camera. Down below, and in that intersection area, this big, huge spot underneath the bridge, there was this huge bridge plate made out of plywood. And I mean, they're like, you know, 3/8 inch thick almost. They're thicker than a quarter. It's like 5/16 inch thick plywood. And, you know, people have talked over the years, I've read them online, about trying to get in there and replace the bridge plate to help with the sound, you know, leave the double X or whatever. The problem is it takes up that entire area, and trying to get that bridge plate out through the sound hole with any tools is damn near impossible. So this just is another candidate for what I call the Resto-Mod treatment. My X-bracing conversion. And it also needed some other things. The truss rod was functioning, but was very stiff, and I'm very leery about the old brass nut truss rods. You start tightening them up too much, they have a tendency to snap. So I did the whole treatment on this one. The frets were really worn, so it needed a fret job. So on the bench it went. First thing first, fretboard came off, neck comes off. Had a crack in the heel itself, so the first thing I did is fix that up. While the fretboard was off, I routed out, removed the old truss rod, and routed a groove for a sound hole access two-way adjustable hot rod truss rod. So it's a 4mm Allen wrench through the sound hole like a Martin. And then I refilled the whole area underneath the truss rod cover with a big ebony block. You know, Gibsons have been breaking necks for years, and even though this one does have, you know, Gibson's small 70s style volute where it's a little thicker, I thought, well, it can't hurt. So that's all been filled in with ebony up top. So now the truss rod is in, pulled all the frets off of the fretboard, and the fretboard was off, so it made refretting it easy. And I re-radiused the fretboard, cleaned it all up, got rid of all the old divots and scratches and chips here and there, and refretted it with some medium / higher, which is one of Stu Mac's sizes. They're just a little smaller than a jumbo, but I would almost call them jumbo nickel frets. So it's been refretted, new truss rod, re-radiused the fretboard, reinforced the top. So now onto the body. Binding came off, the back comes off, and all the bracing came out of the top. And there's a picture in my listing here of that. I'll try to remember to stick it at the end of the video too. You can see the old double X brace, like we can see that shadow, and you can see the great big huge bridge plate. And now let's go to town. So it's got 1/4 inch scalloped and tapered, fairly lightweight, but you know, beefy enough for a dread, Canadian spruce with a Maine maple bridge plate. It's some beautiful maple I get from my son-in-law's farm, and this stuff was milled 25 years ago or so, so it's nice and hard. 1/10 inch thick, not much bigger than the bridge, pretty small. So I like to keep a small bridge plate to let that top ring out. Cleaned up a couple of cracks. There are two cracks on this top. One is right here and one is right there, the basic your belly ones. Small crack over here, which is really just through the finish. I couldn't see it on the inside at all, but these have been cleated. It's got a standard X, somewhat forward shifted. It's about an inch and a quarter back from the sound hole. Small maple bridge plate, two tone bars, two finger braces, new transverse brace across the top because I needed a hole to go through to get to that truss rod. So completely rebraced. Also checked the thickness all the way around on this with my long arm calipers, and it's about 0.105 inches thick all the way around. There's a story, whether it's true or not, about when they did these double X bracing, Norland Gibson decided to see if they could thin the tops down even more and bring them down to like 0.9. And apparently they did some test runs, and then the story goes, whether this is true or not, that they forgot and they set their thickness sander and they actually pumped out a couple hundred guitars with these really thin tops. I had one that was a J-45 Deluxe, very similar to this one, and it was 0.0875. It was so thin that even with all that extra bracing, it didn't save the top. The thing had about 8 cracks across the top, down on the belly and all over the place. And I rebuilt that one and braced it and cleated all the tops, and the guy that has it loves it. But at any rate, once I finished up with all the bracing, the back went back on. It's got brand new ABS black binding on the back to match the top binding. And then I went ahead and refinished the back. If you look at the end here, you can see where a lot of the nitro was flaking. Now, I really didn't want to redo all the sides. I like the finish crazing and checking that the sides have, and I think the sides are beautiful. So I left them alone. I figured that the finish nitro cracking and chipping on the butt area was not that bad, and you know, you can live with it. But the back, there was big flakes missing, and when I pulled the back off, it just made it worse because the back was flexing as I was pulling it. So that's been refinished. I think I matched the color pretty well, and I just left it sort of a satin open pore finish. It's just been true oil. There's about 15 coats of true oil on there, and then it's been buffed out on my buffing wheel, and it is how it is. Same thing all over the whole guitar, just a light wipe of true oil. I love this stuff. It's a gunstock oil. It's basically linseed oil with a polymer agent in it, so it does cure nice and hard. And all around, you know, the neck heel and all that, it's all been done. But she's a real player now. She's loud. The longer scale, longer than most J45s. In the Norland era, these are 25.4, 25.5, whatever they call it, but it's 25.4 when I measure it with a yardstick. Makes me want to belt out things that you strum. I mean, it's a flat picking kind of guitar. You can finger pick it, and my basic finger style will work, but it's just loud. Thank you. first thing in the morning. My fingers aren't quite there yet, but... Anyway, 1973 to 75 is my guess based on the serial number. Norland era Gibson J-45, completely rebuilt. New frets, new truss rod, all new X-brace conversion, refinished back, original sides and top, brand new Gibson Clouson style tuners. It's got a new bone saddle, original bone nut. Really affordable way. I priced it to where I think it's fair. You know, it's non-original, so that changed, although original Norland is not really anything people are searching for much, but non-original, so the X-bracing being different. But for the amount of time and effort and everything that's been done, this is a reworked, completely rebuilt guitar that's good for another 50 years, and it's a 50-year-old Gibson. So got a nice tweed case going with it. Anyway, thanks for watching. See you.